something over there. Run, Adair! Oh crap. They're stomping all over the place. At least they wasted it, right? I'm assuming they can only use it once per combat. Get closer. Oh wait. Oh, switch your weapon back. There you go. Oh god, I didn't even get to knock him over. I hate when they do that. Let's try to frighten them that way. He's still casting his thing. He's done, so he can put blessing. Hit one of these guys. Alright, we're all going. Oh, Maneha isn't doing anything. Oh my god, Adair. Skeletons. He's still trying to cast that. Well, she's standing right next to him. Are they frozen again? They killed the skeletons already. I can't cast him yet. Or she's messed up. She's sickened, terrified. Sheesh. He's paralyzed. Not a pig anymore, but he's paralyzed. Alright, do that. I want to summon Concelhaut's visage or whatever the hell. Armor of Faith. Damn. I should be healing, not... okay. We belay that order. He's still paralyzed. She's got a spell for that. or she did. I think I removed the ring or bracelet or whatever that gave it. That she gave it to her. Sheesh. I forget what it's called. So please stand by while I check it out. There's a fourth level spells. Second level? I think it's this thing. Suppress affliction. And meanwhile... Okay, is he finally free? No uses left. Can we cast this Concelhaut thing? Yes. Destroy my enemies. Alright, now we got Concelhaut. It's a one target, okay. Alright, we need to heal again. This is tough. Oh, he's trying to cast that. Arcane Veil, instant. Oh my god. Lay hands. He's trying to get a heal off anyway. Just Maneha. Tell you a shout, maybe they'll make a difference. Knock this guy down. He cast it already. She's still messed up. Minaha's out. She's almost out. So I don't know if she can take that. I didn't hear the sound. Oh, nice. Yeah, these are real tough battles. In case you haven't noticed. Lava. Oh, the hammer thing, nice. That skeleton is not in the fight anymore, is he? Oh my god. Sheesh, man. He's... Oh man, that's no good. There's not a lot of options here. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Aloth is down for the count, unfortunately. What if I take... He's got this thing on. Arcane Veil, which is helping him, I think. At least, I think. Oh, we killed that guy? Nice. Aloth, man. What I think would be great if he could actually take... Oh, he doesn't have one. How about Wizard's Double? What's that? Mirrored Image? What's better? Plus 25 deflection or Wizard's Double? Plus 40 deflection. Alright, Wizard's Double. I was gonna have him take a regen potion, but... This thing's almost dead.
Yeah.
Nice! That would be crazy, man. He has another use of this thing, though? Almost dead. Now he's got this staff. It's pretty cool that even though Theodas fell, he still gets to fight. Oh, nice. I think we're gonna finish this fight with frickin' Concelhaut and Aloth. That's insane. Again. Killing Bolt. Seriously. That's insane.
Lay him low.
That's awesome, though. Oh, I'm so happy now. I don't think there's too many more of these guys. The skeleton is still, like, after image of it or something. Exceptional ones. Robe.
No problem.
Alright, we need to go back. Rest. Look at poor Adair. Hopefully we'll find some camping supplies soon. Woo! That was crazy. I can't believe Aloth and Dead Concelhaut saved the day. That was awesome. Yeah, he's a lot more powerful than summoning those skeletons. Alright, gonna quick save. Okay, so we've got this area up here and we've got this. We're gonna check out more of this boardwalk. There might be some more of these guys. The skeletons and stuff like that. But they're going to be vastly reduced in number, at least. Oh yay, a camping supply! Nice. Badwin's Notes and Scroll of Prayer Against Imprisonment. This weathered piece of parchment holds a series of nearly illegible notes and what appears to be some kind of diagram. A series of symbols lines the periphery of a crudely drawn circle. One particular set of five symbols has been repeatedly circled. Okay, I wonder if this is to help our poor friend in the southeast corner of the map, stuck in that corpse thing. Yes, it is. I found a note on the corpse of a wizard describing some of the symbols around the ritual circle. Perhaps this will help me get Benno out of the trap. I'm sure he'd appreciate that. You had to go through all that crap to find that. Wish you could go in some of these homes, that'd be cool. Okay, so all we have to look at is up there now. Glad we found a camping supply. Hold on a second, guys. Okay, let's check this out. A wall of thick vines rises from the mud of the bog. They grow in unnatural, twining cords, bristling with thorns. Though there are gaps between the vines, maneuvering through will take some care and time. Well, staying here won't do any good, so let's go through. As you approach the vines, they shudder and pull away from you, forming a clear path through which to cross. Interesting. You pass safely, only to hear rustling behind you as the vines bar a passage, curling into a tight knot of thorns and vegetation. Hello? Uh-oh. You notice movement up ahead. A robed figure rushes forward, stumbling through the muck. He blows a single, piercing tone on a signal horn. We're gonna die again, aren't we? The sound carries through the bog, echoing off the cloistered trees and ruins. Beneath it, you hear an ominous rumble, and the murky water to the north begins to bubble in pitch. Okay. There's a boss battle. I thought he was calling, like, you know, 20 of these, 20 more of these friggin' guys. Oh. Is that a dragon? A slick, scaly snout crests the water's surface. It is the only warning you receive before a massive beast rises from the bog in a shower of mud and bog water. The dragon shakes vegetation from its horns, then lowers its head to set a keen eye upon you. Wave. Wave. Hold our ground? The dragon watches you disinterestedly. It stands still, as if waiting. You notice a small, dark shape in a distance. You feel a sudden, buffeting gust of wind from above as the shape grows. A winged silhouette descends swiftly upon the clearing. Another dragon? As the second dragon comes to a heavy landing, you take note of the figure atop its back, a woman with sweeping horns, garbed in flowing robes. She slides from the dragon's back in one graceful movement. Well, she's getting off the dragon. She's not attacking us by having the dragon fly by and stuff. Can we parley? I really don't want to. I don't want to.
The Watcher of Cadnua. I expected you'd find us eventually.
Oh, yeah?
I'm a little more surprised to find you're still carrying that abomination around. I imagine Concelhaut is better company without his tongue.
Llengrath. Who are you?
I am Llengrath.
She bows slightly at the waist. I thought Llengrath was a man.
As was my predecessor. He too lives on in me. We are all, you see, Llengrath.
Okay.
Llengrath knew something Concelhaut did not. The brevity of life should be embraced, not feared. Each generation brings with it renewed strength and saves us from stagnation. When his time came, Llengrath was willing to let go, to leave his memories and body behind. He entrusted the gift of his life force, his vibrant spirit, to a worthy successor. Concelhaut clung to his pathetic existence like a leech. And there are others like him, who would see all the world serve as kindling, if only their flame can go on burning.
Well, he's dead now. It's just his spirit that helps me.
Concelhaut's knowledge cannot outlive him.
She looks at you pointedly. Can we reason with her? Aren't you doing the same thing? Transferring souls?
You misunderstand. A wolf devouring a hare has done nothing outside its nature. One life feeds the next. Ours is the work of generations, many minds coming together to strengthen one another.
That's why you were after the phylactery? To destroy it?
More than that. To ensure it could never be replicated. You yourself could easily have become the latest tool in Concelhaut's efforts to thwart the wheel and place himself beyond the reach of time. He would have used your very essence for fuel. A lesser death than you deserve, I think. But you made it out.
Well, thanks.
In truth, I am glad you came. It saves me the effort of chasing you.
How is it you are working with such creatures?
These two? They're quite young, but already appallingly bright.
Maybe we have a chance against them?
There's no greater aim than to leave behind a lasting legacy, to teach those who will learn.
If they're like, just like really strong drakes, we might be okay.
Llengrath's teachings are interesting.
Gafanarkos.
We will strengthen our souls as they do. Morgach Ian will be our home for eons.
All this time I thought I said Morgrek Fen. Why is the phylactery so dangerous?
Think on it. You must have seen how desperately Kith cling to their lives. What measures they're willing to take to ensure theirs is the consciousness that lingers longest. The phylactery was to be Concelhaut's great triumph over death. All the evil that Kith have done in search of falsehoods would pale in the face of what they will do for the truth.
I am not sure everyone's as willing as Concelhaut was to carve up their own skulls.
It only takes one.
Concelhaut and I weren't exactly friends.
And for killing him, at least, I do thank you. But you should not have interfered. Commander Balorin would have brought me the phylactery. All of this could have been avoided.
Why hire the Torn Bannerman anyway?
Discretion. It would hardly have been ideal to fly in atop Gavinerkos and get the attention of every dragon hunter in the region.
Oh, that's how you say that dragon's name.
I'd heard the Bannermen were competent. It turns out that you're more competent.
I don't want to give her the phylactery. Wait, at least help me understand.
It's not as if you'll understand for very long. But as you wish.
Were you and Concelhaut always enemies?
No, not at all. Oh, he and the original Llengrath were distantly aware of each other, I'm sure, being masters in their field.
Oh, right. This Llengrath is the one behind, like, Llengrath's displaced image and all that?
I learned of his obsessions too late. Perhaps if we'd been on better terms, I could have convinced him to reconsider. Too late in any case. My apologies, Concelhaut.
She smiles at the floating skull. How did you become Llengrath?
A great deal of study, and a little magic. Once a suitable candidate has been selected, their predecessor gives up his life and essence, and the soul is transferred. I studied for many years, and was selected. But at any step, I might have turned away, buried myself in common living. My choice was to stay.
You don't find that unnatural?
Not at all. The energy of souls is a natural force all around us. Every being leaves traces of their passing, even as their essence finds root in new soil. We accept that the cycle exists, and that death will come. It is what we leave behind that matters. A life bettered by our efforts.
Do you possess more than Llengrath's title? What about his memories?
His memories, his awareness, those died with him. But his power remains. As a watcher, you must have seen by now that certain spirits possess more strength than others.
Indeed.
His knowledge we secure in the usual way. It is my hope that we will someday spread Llengrath's teachings beyond our numbers.
Your books are too small to read. Better to learn it in song.
Song?
No, no singing.
The dragon grinds its jaws. I kind of feel like saving this for last. Why are you out here?
Why? Because it's quiet. Out of the way. The local wildlife keeps out the rabble.
She laughs.
I've never minded being out in the open air. But some of the apprentices found it difficult at first. But a bright young mind that can't survive contact with blood and dirt will fare very poorly in this world.
I found some of your victims in the bog.
Intruders, mostly. How pleasant it would be to live in a world where nothing unfortunate ever happened to those who didn't deserve it, don't you think?
Yeah, I guess.
That would be dreadful.
Well, I'm not a wizard. It's too bad Aloth can't speak for me. That's all I wondered about?
A curious mind is a gift. Perhaps your soul will retain that quality.
Huh. I don't want to give it to her, but what if I just say this? What if I just give you the phylactery? The moment the words pass your lips, you feel a wave of anger extruding from the skull at your side.
We could simply take it from you. After.
You don't want to fight me.
To the contrary. I would relish the challenge. Let's match horns, you and I. There could be no worthier contest.
Come and fight me then. All right, guys, it's been real.
Better luck on the next turn of the wheel, my friend. I'm sure you'll be remembered.
Who should we focus on? I got two frickin' dragons and this who's bound to be very powerful.
I've never eaten a watcher before.
I'm pretty sure I taste the same as anyone else. I was afraid of this. Llengrath is set on taking my life. I must now contend with her and her draconic allies.